Hey kids, this is Books from My Study, and this is actually an update on the last book that I just did. I wanted to give you an update on Inferno by Dan Brown. I finished it. I would rather you spend your time using this mechanism right here. It's called a PSP, and there are a lot of really fun games, and the game that I'm playing right now, it was recommended to me by Courtney W., and it is Final Fantasy VII Crisis Core. And so far, I have gotten through several levels and lost my mind and broken my heart and screamed and cried and found out more about Zack than I ever thought I would, and I'm enjoying the heck out of it, and it's really, really well written and beautifully designed, and I'm having a blast. For those of you who know more about PSPs, please come help me, because I'm actually having quite a bit of a problem like controlling these things, and the fact that people can dodge blows is really freaking me out. The other game that I got was Desida, and I'm very excited to start playing that. I haven't had a chance to play it yet. So to make up for asking you guys to acknowledge the fact that I read maybe one of the dumber books I've read in my entire life, the book is not really that bad. The end is just rotters. It's just absolute garbage. Spoiler alert, it's a big stupid virus that will somehow render one-third of the world infertile, but the virus will choose to do whatever it wants to do and blah, blah, blah. And for some reason, they chose to get an art history professor to help them battle biogenetic warfare, because... you know, obviously, you know, that's why I was asked to go to space and land on a meteorite and help them plant bombs, because I teach English, you know, this is, duh. Dante would probably be really sad to know that his name was used in this book a lot. Although, to be honest with you, actually, no, he wouldn't. Dante would probably be thrilled to know that we're still talking about him and his dumb hat. So anyway, so since that book was bad science, I want you to think about good science, and good science is Stephen Hawking's A Brief History of Time. We don't discuss Hawking's at our school very much, and that is too bad, because this guy is freaking awesome. Not only is this book very approachable, very easy to read, it comes with cute little pictures. It's lovely, and this man's life is really quite astounding when you think he has what's commonly called Lou Gehrig's disease, and he's unfortunately on, you know, a limited amount of time that he can spend on this planet, and he has a life of the mind, which is, you know, it's quite literally he is forced to have a life of the mind. But his mind is so intensely beautiful, and it's so constantly moving forward and being curious and inspiring us to find our own path of curiosity, that he's one of the reasons that I picked up the electronic gadgets for the evil genius, and I just recently bought myself my own soldering iron, which hopefully over the summer I'm going to build my own Faraday cage. Why, you ask? Because I say. There's not enough curiosity on the planet, so if you guys can just start being dorkier, more curious people, having more fun with science and life and literature and art, then that would be great. And I apologize for offering the Inferno. My bad. But I'm making up for it by this awesome book. So I will read this and I will give you guys an update on tomorrow's Books for My Study. So I just wanted to send out a quick one and say, Inferno. Nope. Stay away from it. Avoid it like the plague. Cards are behind it. I now can see ahead. Often I wonder why I try. Side note, we are obviously the descendants of the people who survived the bubonic plague. Sorrow so, weighs my shoulders down, and trouble haunts my mind. Our ancestors obviously lived. But I know the